Happy Homebrew Wednesday, everybody. This is SJ Poor, Little Face Brewing. I think you're getting the idea on what I'm doing. Yes, indeed, it is time. This thing going. It's time to bottle the Monster IPA. Part 3 in the Revolutionary Series of beers. These are whiskey barrel beers. So the deal with this started out to be a... what was this? It's a huge IPA. The original recipe was really fashioned after another big IPA, and I apologize. Heady Topper. That's what the base recipe started out as, is a Heady Topper. This right here is still my cream ale. Gotta love those kegs that never end, right? So, basically, like I said, very, very, very loosely, very, 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 very loosely based off of Heady Topper. And I say that because, like I said, we started out as a Heady Topper. And then we ventured away from a wee. I say Kimbo Cracker, he actually helped with this beer. And we ventured off of that recipe pretty quickly. And pretty substantially. Yeah, basically the only thing that we stayed with on the Heady Topper was like the base malts, and that's pretty much it. The hops, we started off using their hops, and then I ended up, the IBUs on this one was actually up in the 124 IBUs, which is pretty substantial. Pretty substantial indeed. So, loosely based off of the Heady Topper. The hop schedule's different. There's like four, I forget what the, I'll look at the recipe and I'll put in here the hop schedule. Right in here. So that right there is what the hop schedule was for this beer. Took it from there, and I did something with it that you don't normally do with an IPA, and that is, I decided to put it in my whiskey barrel, and I let it set in the whiskey barrel for... Oh, it was at least 2 months, sat in the whiskey barrel. Pulled it out of the whiskey barrel. And I'm overkilling. I actually have a cleaner and a sanitizer, and then I'm also re-rinsing the sanitizer here before I put it on the bottle tree. But anyways, about 2 months in the whiskey barrel. Then I pulled it out of the whiskey barrel. We dry hopped it with another, I want to say, 4 ounces of hops. And those hops are right here. So once I got done with that, we pulled it out of the whiskey barrel, put those, and then I put in a second, or actually a tertiary. And Then I pulled it out of that, and I set it in a four fermenter to let it set and clean up, because it was pellet hops that I used, and I didn't use any bags. So I didn't use any bags with that, so you had all the pellet hop residue all over the in, you know, all over the inside. So that's actually been sitting for another month. So that's what we have sitting right now. So I'm gonna get back to cleaning, because y'all don't need to see this mess. You've seen it a thousand times. I'm using bombers. That way I don't have to clean as many bottles. It takes it down to from 54 to 29. Love the bombers. Love the big bottles. So, bottles are clean. Beer is transferring into the bottling bucket. Bottling bucket is clean. Sample has been pulled. Holy moly, I can already see. This thing is way down there. Let me try and get you. We are hard to tell, there's a little bit of a, there we go, it's been around a little bit. One, there we go, fermented out the whole way down to one. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. So let's say we give her a taste. Alrighty. So we're down to one. So let's give it a taste. There we go. Color is really nice, dead on. It's that burnt orange, clear. I'm picking up the oak. I'm still picking up the oak, which I'm surprised with. I would have thought the dry hop would have took care of some of that. But I'm not really picking up the aroma from the dry hop, from the hops. Although I'm getting it when you swirl her up a little bit. So the carbonation, when this thing carbonates, it's going to have some... Oh yeah, it's gonna have a phenomenal aroma. Wow. I get almost a little touch of an orange there. Nice. Let's give her a try. Oh yeah. Wow. Is that an assault on your senses right there? Because you're getting everything. This could be one of the most interesting beers I've ever had. Wow. Picking up the whiskey. I'm picking up the oak. Completely separate. The hops are there. The heat from the alcohol is there. Dries off. I mean, when it's done, it is done, and it leaves a nice sweetness as an aftertaste. Oh my goodness. See, this right here is why we brew beer. Love bottling bombers. Way better than 12s. I'm still drinking on this. This is, my God, is this good. Mm.
Yeah. That's just crazy. Don't fear the foam. I'm sure you guys all seen this 1,000 times. However, not so sure that you've seen that. So this was part one of a 2 or 3 part little kind of series or whatever. This whole first one obviously was the IPA, bottling up the IPA from the Revolutionary series of beers. Stay tuned for the next one coming up. We'll split it up, that way the videos aren't quite as long. Anyways, I'm out of here. Enjoy the fruits of your labor, folks. Brew beer.